idea behind Wild Davis was that we would give the same sort of experience and the same sort of skill building to students who aren't in the biology majors, give them a lot of the same exposure to ecological observation, practicing the scientific method, getting out in nature and doing a lot of the same sort of skill building that the major specific courses do. One of the things I've been building into the class is also trying to make all of the activities that we do serve some sort of bigger research need or management need on campus, which works a lot with the capstone projects out here at Stebbins too, that the idea is a lot of work needs to be done out here, and how can we contribute at least in a small way to the management needs of Stebbins.
Yeah, so everything that we do out here is obviously non-mechanized. So everything we've got to do by hand. If you want materials, you've got to haul them in. So we do a lot of on-site, you know, harvesting, and so yeah, you can see an example of that, you know. Closing up an erosion site. The student groups just like opened a whole new door in terms of, you know, resources that can really help us get stuff done.
For the capstone project for the class, I contributed to some of the trail restoration work out at Stebbins Cold Canyon. I also was a part of some noxious weed surveys and a little bit of work with some of the ground burrowing bees. One thing I really enjoyed about the work we were doing is kind of how tangible it was and really being able to see, like, right in front of us the impact we were making, the positive impact on the trails, and kind of improving it for everyone who uses them.
Most days, if you have a set of binos and you come sit here and you just scan those ridges, you'll see all kinds of animals, foxes, raccoons, if you're lucky, a lion.
The biggest projects we've been doing are the camera trap data sorting, where there's I think 12 now cameras around on the trail. They generate tens of thousands of photos a year. It's an enormous pipeline of data. Paul found a former computer science professor who was interested in setting up an AI tool, and now what the students have been doing the last 2 years is training that AI to identify the photos itself.
I was part of the camera trap tagging and went through, I think, 800,000 photos during that quarter. So it was spread out through a lot of the students, so it made it a lot easier. And it was a new AI system, so it made it a little tough a couple times, but it was not too bad.
There's already been some really interesting data come out of that. There's ringtails in the area, which they didn't know about. We found a badger last year in one of the photos, which we didn't know were out here. And so there's some really cool wildlife and ecological data in there, and it's also really interesting for the students going through and seeing some of these cool photos. The basic thing I want them to take away is engagement with nature and really getting outside of a classroom and seeing what cool things you can learn when you're not in a desk with a PowerPoint in front of you.
I'm looking to apply to PhD programs right now, and I really want to focus on community and citizen science and work with the types of topics and fields and areas that California Naturalist works through. And so to have that experience as an undergrad was super useful to affirm that this is where I want to follow and what I want to go through.
To be involved with the management of a protected area, but with a focus of facilitating research and educating, you know, especially the up-and-coming generations, is really a privilege.